Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 3. As per usual, we are just jumping right on in here. Excuse me. Now, where we last left off, I was poking around. We were going to find some super fruit, or some Punga tree, and Outrider pointed out to me, yes, there's a mini nuke sitting right here, and I didn't notice it. Professionalism. It's, you know, what I strive for. Punga fruit. These things are actually worth a pretty decent amount of money. Oh, seriously, that one fruit's gonna over-encumber me. Of course. Probably because of my opiate withdrawal, right? Yeah. Hey, morphine. Feels good, man. Okay. So we'll use this for the time being. So, Fallout 4 got announced yesterday, I think. That's certainly a thing. They're showing off some pretty interesting stuff for it, Bethesda was. I mean, it's from what I saw in the trailer, it was more good than bad, I would say. Outrider had mentioned that the world seemed a bit empty, and I agree with that. The world is still pretty empty, at least from what we've seen in the trailers. I'm hopeful that you'll be able to kind of change that, though, due to the ability to, like, make your own trading posts and stuff. I mean, that's probably kind of artificial, but, you know, it's better than nothing. He was also appreciative of the fact that there was some green in the color palette, which I can also appreciate, because, you know, years after a nuclear explosion, plants and stuff would be back, you know, not everything would be under this, you know, death haze. But hey, whatever. So, maybe that'll be decent. I'm hopeful. I'm not gonna pre-order it. But, temptation was there. If I were gonna do it though, I'd be the Pip-Boy edition, simply because it comes with a fucking Pip-Boy. But, I am very strongly against pre-ordering things, so I have no intention of doing so. So we have bloat flies. I haven't seen these guys in a little while. They're tough blowflies, dang. Well, except for that one. That was like the little blowfly that could. Why am I slow again? I shouldn't be. Oh, AP. I was like, where's my movement speed, damn it? Why am I not running? Alright, go ahead and quick save. Reload. There's some normal blowflies. Okay. And a first aid box with a stim pack, and a sack with some food, and a bed. I think this worries me. Bog entrance. In we go. Go ahead and pop on our little Pip-Boy light here. Hopefully get through this without too much horror. I'm sure this is probably gonna be bad. But, you know, we do what we do. We run, we gun, and we make stuff dead. Okay. Punga fruit plant. I was gonna say, oh, maybe we found like the first not irradiated water in the game, but doesn't appear to be the case. Seriously? Oh, okay. This is an interior that looks like an exterior. Fascinating. Something hostile. Some things. Oh god. God damn it, shotgun. Seriously? Down, boy. Oh, and we have a crash. That's just beautiful. Okay, we're back. No idea. Fallout being Fallout. One thing, though, I am curious about, with all the stuff that they're adding to Fallout 4, it has me legitimately curious about what modders are going to do to it, because of like how they're doing weapons and stuff. There is a lot of room for modders to like just go absolutely nuts. Come on. How do you use a dart gun? Such a waste of bullets. That's just a rock. So here's the dart gun. Go ahead and quick save here. Now, I don't think that this thing really does much in the way of damage. It's basically purely for crippling wounds. Well, that is like some excellently designed stuff right there. I mean, damn. You go, game devs. Okay, so we've got to go this way. That's where we came from. Like, seriously, what? They forgot to put the water in or something? Ugh. I don't know. It says we gotta go that way, but I think we probably gotta go this way because I think I saw a little bridge. So I guess I'm sure I'm gonna start eating radiation as soon as I touch this water. Oh, yeah. Ah, and it's of course a dead end. Hatchling meat, huh? Sure. I'll take that. That's healing. Anything else? Anything else? No. Okay. Oh, delicious rads. Tastes like burning. Oh. Yeah, because like that right there looks like a bridge of some sort, but apparently it wasn't from that way. Okay, I'm actually going to come in and we're going to chow on a Radex and a Radaway here. Hopefully this will kind of offset the horror a little bit. Yeah, that's pretty bad. Oh yeah, instead of 6 rads a second, now we're getting 1. Hey there, bro. Oh no. I was saying, yeah, that should cripple your legs, you jerks. I just went out of this water. I don't know how useful this is, in all truthfulness. I love this shotgun. This shotgun is the best shotgun ever. Alright, well that other one went running off somewhere. I don't even friggin' know. Is this like a thing right here? No, it's just a creepy little doll. Alright. Then reload. As I say, I know! God, the health on these things is just insane. I was honestly, I'm surprised that was the first one. I was waiting for them. I was expecting them somewhat earlier. But we're going to have ourselves a little feast here of Myrlurk meat. And sure, why not? All of our Myrlurk meat and we're going to be so full. Oh, hey, Stimpak. Thank you. The pork and beans, which... completely uninterested in the hunger, -215%. They should, I know in New Vegas, they give you penalties for overeating. Like, I know if you drink too much, you get like basically like water on the brain. It's weird. Okay, so we got some bear traps. Hanging. Dolls, more bear traps. Quick saves. It's almost like somebody doesn't want me coming this way or something. Huh. There we go. And apparently, yes, there's another one of the nasty ones out there. Here, can I switch to something and just... I'm not going to be able to nail this thing with it. I hate that they do that little downward scuttly charge attack and I have no... There we go. Uh-oh. No bullets. Let's see what a couple headshots will do to him. Like, look at that. The hit points. It's insane. Ow. My hit points. Leave me alone. Dick. This thing just does so much damage. Okay, well, in this case, we'll pop a couple stim packs. Take its meat. Take. Oh, no meat on that one. That one had meat, though. I'm saddened. Myrlurk meat. Soft shell Myrlurk meat. What is Full doing this? -1 agility. Yeah, I don't know. I think you get like a... I think it's called like food coma or something in New Vegas. They also give you a debuff while you're eating, which is interesting. It doesn't last very long, though. Okay, so it's looking like, you know, maybe we've cleared this area. So we'll just move on. Maybe we've cleared this area, or not. Oh. My Lurk Hunter goes down like a sack of crab taters. I don't even know. Potatoes shaped like little crabs. Oh, he saw me. Darn it. Alright, I took two shots just in case. But we didn't need two shots. Oh, that was a Myrlurk claw. I actually do not want that. Miscellaneous. Myrlurk claw. I apparently grabbed one earlier too and didn't even realize it. Oh. Aw, dang it. Come on. Like, seriously, Myrlurk Hunter. That's one. That's two. I gotta hit him once on my own. Oh, and of course. What in the hell is that thing teleporting around? Oh, the weapon jams are getting old. Domed that one, though. Ah, took its claw. What has he got on him? Soft shell Myrlurk meat and some Myrlurk meat. Nice. Once again, we must drop the claw. Do I not have any? Oh, I apparently don't have any repair kits left either. That rustles my jimmies a little bit. Alright, there's one sitting out there. I'm just gonna give it a bullet here. And it's running! No escape. We are getting close to leveling, though. If we're lucky, we'll actually pop a level on this episode. Would be kind of cool. I think that put us at, I want to say 15. It tells you every time the experience comes up, but I haven't been paying attention. But I think it's 15. Okay. And they're just making us take this most roundabout way. I hope I don't have to, well, nah, they probably won't give me like a drop down or something. I'd hope they don't make me run back out through all this. I'm gonna guess maybe not. Hey there, you creepy freaking thing. Oh, it gassed me. Damn it. But I'm okay, apparently. Thanks, you screwy freaking plants. So I wanna make sure I have the seeds. I do in fact have the seeds. And are they seriously going to make me walk all the way out of here? Okay, giant pit boy. Oh, is this gonna be like a freaking acid trip? Bobblehead intelligence. This disc walked right into another trap. Exactly. How stupid are you? So stupid. So friggin' stupid. I wouldn't say stupid. Devon is more good-natured than stupid. I mean, he's got an intelligence of, you know, whatever. 7 or 8, I think. This one say. Inscription reads, "In one, this is one situation you're not going to be able to fight your way out of." Okay. We'll see about that. I got mini nukes. I'll set traps with them. Oh, hey. Keep it up. You're almost there, or wherever there might be. Probably nowhere. Okay. Okay. this one. Isn't it funny how everything you get close to ends up leaving? Jeez, game, that's mean. Now my feelings are hurt. Dang. Ooh, okay. I don't know, honestly, this is fairly well done. I'm not even gonna complain. Whoa. Doesn't look right, not right at all. Oh, like, that's pretty cool. Somebody suturing the land, I think, yeah. Okay. What Devon gets for, like, it's shooting up all that morphine all the time. Blech. If my kid looked like that, I'd abandon it too. Mom. Well, that's just terrible. Oh, we got a body floating in the water. The dead settler. And if you search them, they poof out. Oh, there's lions. Moira. Nobody cares about Moira. I care about Moira. She's okay. Bomb from Megaton. Dead mother, life in a post-nuclear wasteland, and not a friend in it. Yeah, you aren't exactly blessed. This D-bag.
No, don't try and get up yet. You'll only hurt your...
Okay, then. Oh, that explains the bag. Alright. No, none of this. I'm not playing you damn bloatflies' game. I hate bloatflies, they're so hard to hit because they bob around so much. Oh my god, I'm not wasting my good guns ammo on these stupid things. And I need morphine. Aid. Morphine. Okay. There. They're dead. Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and fast travel. Back. Actually, I think here, so we can offload some stuff and repair our gear. Because I think that's what we should probably do. We also have a quest to turn in for the Moonshine Lady. Oh.
Greetings once again.
Show me what you got for sale.
I knew that's why you came to me.
Actually, you repair some stuff for me.
Of course. I learned many tricks from my father.
Repair everything. Wow, your lady, your repair skill is terrible. Oof. You can't repair things for me.
I knew that's why you came to me.
Okay, so in that case, I'm gonna have to figure out somewhere else to repair things. Because, like, there's not enough money just floating around for me to be able to jump from, you know, one area to another. I think we only need two of these. I'm gonna hold on to three just in case. Jet. Mini nukes I'm holding on to. They're actually worth quite a bit. Morphine I'm keeping. Cigarettes can go. Pork and beans can go. As can potato crisps. We're okay on food now, I think. I'm gonna keep some of it. But I don't need a ton of it. And these things, I do not need 50 of them. I'm gonna go ahead and sell 30 of them. Okay, lady. Okay, where's my gun list? There's my gun list. Always hiding somewhere. I honestly she have 30 out six? She does. 12 apiece. Yeah, I want, like, 15 of those. Okay. Alright, we gotta go. So doped up. All of my everythings are wearing off. Where is... I think it was Marguerite Shack was the moonshiner. We will come talk to her. Let's see, I remember the door was around the front. Shut up, Devon. You can sit there and clear your throat all you want. I give no fucks. Hey there.
My, look at you.
Okay.
Well, if it ain't my favorite out-of-towner.
Dude, let's talk about your tonic.
We need to gather up the ingredients.
That's enough punga fruit for you?
Wild fruit, eh? Just as good, if a slight weaker for flavor.
See here. Batteries for extra kick.
You best keep this one to yourself, sweetie. The family tonic gets real kick from our secret ingredient. We need just a little bit of battery acid. Oh, don't look like that now. You reckon I'd be around to tell you about it if it weren't safe enough? Bring me 6 fishing...
6, okay.
Well, we'll need yeast. You can find it about anywhere, but there's a big...
And 3 yeast. All right. I don't know where I got 6 and 2 from. Or 2 and 2 from, rather. All right, that's fine. I'm sure we will find it. I'm not exactly in a hurry. So, whatever. God, we were like right on level 15. All right, you dingbats, open your damn gate.
You are welcome to our tribe.
Damn right. Hey,
truly, the Mother Punga has bestowed her wisdom upon you, and your mind has been expanded.
What happened? Why does my head hurt so much?
That is merely the sensation of your consciousness rushing to embrace its true potential. It is the feeling of having no boundaries, no limits. Yea, though your body will bear the scars of the ritual, your soul shall be forever strengthened by the experience. You are now welcome in our cathedral. Enter, enlightened brother.
Punga power perk. All right. Better effects from eating punga fruit. Okay. Oh yeah, that's gonna be a level for us right there. Okay, why did you attack the mansion? We're gonna be straightforward.
Our most enlightened one divined that the fates themselves did decree the mansion must be burnt to the ground.
Okay, who leads this tribe?
Leader? That would be Jackson, a man of great wisdom. He has withdrawn to his cavern of communion, the better to contemplate the unknowable. Only the righteous are trusted to know where this nexus of understanding lies. And alas, I am not so blessed.
Hey, what does this tribe believe in?
We espouse the expansion of the perfect mind, and the rejection of the corrupt physical. The material world is destroyed and imperfect. We seek to release our minds from their tainted cages, so as to find a better world.
Okay. Okay, so he doesn't know where Jackson is. So how do you get so much punga fruit to grow here?
It is a gift from the earth itself, in acknowledgement of our perfect balance with nature and the higher planes. She recognizes that we seek to leave behind the corrupt physical, and she nurtures us in our quest.
Okay. Bye.
May you find...
Okay, level up. What do I want to do? I think I want to get medicine to 75, and then repair. Okay, let's see, level 15, what do we get? Anything fun? Tag. No, we don't get anything new. All right. Learn to hold your hand steady when fighting. Accuracy with all guns outside of vats. That's honestly really tempting, the extra health, because stimpaks heal so much less. Strong back is also tempting for extra carrying capacity. But honestly, our carrying capacity isn't too terrible, all things considered. That could be nice, too. I don't know. No radiation from drinking irradiated water. Toughness is nice. I think I'm... I'm gonna take natural born sniper. Because extra damage. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and quick save here. Let's see, we're at, I think, 26 or 27 minutes. So I actually think I'm gonna call it an episode here. I think we're at, what, 64? 65. Alright, and next time we're gonna probably deal with a bunch of conversating. That's why I am calling it a little early here. So, yeah. We will do that then, and I'm figuring that it's probably going to end up with us killing that guy in the mansion, because he seems like kind of an asshole, not of the kind that I'm like rabble about, but of the kind I find hilarious, so whatever. Anyways, as per usual, thank you for watching, and I will catch you all next time. Until then.